cannot imagine our lives without technology. We wake up, unlock our phones with Face ID, and go to school or work, where we use our computers to complete various tasks. On the way home, we might want to order something online, so we click a cluster of pixels and the parcel is at our front door the next day. And technology keeps progressing. Our devices and tools are continually evolving and becoming more intelligent. But why is this happening? Is it because we're too lazy and want the machines to do everything for us? To be honest, I do think that asking Alexa to switch the song when your phone is right beside you is a little extreme. But I genuinely believe that for the most part, individuals want our devices to be more and more intelligent because they hope to make the world a better place. But the main question is, will machines ever achieve a human level of intelligence? And if so, what are the consequences? Although some may think that our current smartphones are the peak of intelligence, most of our technology nowadays relies on massive libraries of algorithms that were pre-installed in them by humans. Presentation of dry facts without analyzing and applying them can hardly be considered intelligent, as there is no place for thinking. Yet, we're coming closer to intelligent machines every day. AI system AlphaGo forever changed the game Go in March 2016, when it won 4 out of 5 games against the top player in the world. And AlphaGo did it by playing millions of games with itself and learning from its mistakes. So, if an AI can replace a professional Go player, where else can it be used instead of us? Automation of labor has already impacted our lives. While it is true that new jobs are being created in some areas, it is also true that many people have lost their jobs to a computer. Occupations such as cashier, janitor, and administrative assistant are rapidly being automated. But what about jobs that require creativity, a unique human trait that technology is believed to lack? Well, in fact, Google and Microsoft are funding a project that is developing artificially intelligent software that will be able to replace journalists. Quite a creative profession, right? One of the staff members said, "I spend all my life reading about how automation and AI is going to take all our jobs. And here I am. AI has taken my job." The reason behind every technological revolution in the history of humanity is the striving for productivity. We've been replacing automated jobs with technology, as it can usually do tasks more efficiently and with fewer resources needed. So maybe goal for intelligence in our technology is actually a desire for greater productivity. Maybe what we need is a super intelligent machine that can replace the entire workforce. Here, we come closer to artificial general intelligence, or AGI. It is a technology of a broad intelligence that could accomplish virtually any goal and do it just as well as humans, or even better. AGI is not built yet, and there is no way we can predict when it might happen. It could be in the near future, or 100 years from now, if ever. But the most important idea is that it's not impossible. So let's assume people will eventually create an AGI. There will be no need for human workers, as AGI will do everything for us. And we must establish whether it's a good change or not. On the one hand, if we do stop working, we will have more free time that can be spent, for example, with our family. Parents could focus on raising their children. Family and social interactions in general could become the core of our being. The way we think about life would change. We won't have this pressure to work to provide for ourselves and our family, as the idea of money might cease to exist, as there will simply be no need for it. We could spend time exploring the world and doing hobbies. The focus would be on individual happiness. From another angle, however, if we do not have to work, what will motivate us to keep progressing? If technology replaces us in almost every aspect of our lives, won't people become lazy and incapable of action? If there is no need to get educated in order to have a job and earn money to eat, then why try at all? With the total automation of labor, people might simply stop learning. And in a couple of generations, humanity would begin to regress. AGI can also change our definition of privacy. We have all come across situations when you search for some item online and in 5 minutes you are bombarded with adverts of the same item. At first it was terrifying, but then we got used to our phone spying on us all the time. The pandemic has only influenced the idea of constant monitoring. The Israel Health Ministry announced an app allowing its citizens to know that someone nearby is diagnosed with COVID or merely looks ill. The technology to track and trace already exists and is being used by governments all around the world. With AGI, we might simply forget about privacy, as total control of our health and movements might become the norm. Perhaps George Orwell's novel 1984 might not be that far from reality. Therefore, if we want to prevent that from happening, boundaries of how far the surveillance should go need to be discussed. What about other dangers? Of course, the first thing that comes to mind is machines rising to power. The reasons why a superior AI would do this might be quite straightforward. It may see us as a threat or a waste of resources. AI does not have to be evil to decide to eliminate humanity. It may simply do what we asked it to do. For example, if we will set our AGI a goal to overcome global warming, a viable solution that it might produce would be to kill all humans, as it is not a secret that we humans are one of the biggest threats to the environment. And if the AGI would set itself this purpose, it won't be so complicated for technology of such intelligence to get rid of us in a way we cannot even imagine. So we need to spend some time thinking about how to teach a computer to be ethical before deciding to build something of that power. I know that it is still in the future, but it is because no one actually knows when and if people will be able to create something so intelligent. We need to start talking more about security now. I believe smart AI could accomplish amazing things, and we should never stop trying to improve it. But I'm just really concerned about that blind rush for intelligence in our technology. Safety is as important as the ability to accomplish complex goals. And we really need to take this into account before designing a new super intelligent robot. Because maybe not now, but someday in the future, we will reach human level of intelligence in our technology. And because we, humans, do everything at the last moment, we might not be prepared for the time when our technology becomes smarter than us. Thank you.